Now, in order to be a functional ACLS provider, one must have the basic knowledge to recognize and treat patients with acute coronary syndromes, otherwise known as ACS. In this section, we'll be learning how to assess and treat the ACS patient following the latest recommendations and guidelines. Now, an initial 12-lead ECG is used as part of the identification process for all ACS cases. The three ECG categories for ACS include ST segment elevation, which suggests an acute myocardial infarction or AMI, ST segment depression suggesting ischemia, and non-diagnostic or a normal ECG. STEMI is going to be the focus of this section as it's the most time sensitive for reperfusion therapies and can limit the amount and extent of the myocardial damage. Now, although 12-lead ECG interpretation is beyond the scope of the ACLS provider course, some practitioners who are ACLS certified will have already been trained in the interpretation and reading of 12-leads. For these particular individuals, this ACS case summarizes identification and treatment of STEMI patients. Remember, the main goal of a STEMI ACS, STEMI meaning ST elevation myocardial infarction, is to reperfuse myocardial tissue that's being damaged by blockage. Reperfusion may involve the use of coronary angiography with balloon, angioplasty, and stenting, otherwise known as PCI. When PCI is used as the initial reperfusion treatment for STEMI, it's referred to as primary PCI. Treatments other than primary PCI include, but aren't limited to, oxygen, aspirin, nitroglycerin, both sublingual tablet or spray, fibrinolytic therapies, and heparin, both UFH, which is unfractionated, or LWMH, meaning low molecular weight heparin.